Hello and welcome to School of Basics. I am Raghav and today we have a very interesting topic to learn, that is machine learning. Now do not worry if you have never understood what exactly is machine learning. I am going to start from very scratch and by the end of this video you will have a complete understanding of the basics of machine learning. Let us take some examples to understand so that before I tell you the official definition of machine learning, you will actually able to understand what exactly it is and then you will be easily able to get the official definition. Think of a time when you had to plan a holiday. Now, whenever you are planning a holiday, you have to predict your expenses, how much you will have to spend and all the expenses you will have to predict. Now it may include the cost of travel. Suppose you are going through flights, you will have to check the flight rates. You will check what will be the cost of hotels at that particular time. You will have to predict for the expenses for all the activities, shopping and the food. All these things you will have to predict and then you can calculate and then you can see what will be your expenses. Now to predict these expenses, you can do a lot of analysis and get information from different sources. For example, you can go to the websites and you can search for the flight ticket prices at that particular time. You can search for the hotel prices at that part of the season, the activities that you have to do, the prices of those activities, the food, shopping, etc. You can get information from internet online websites. You can also look at some reviews and take information from people who have earlier visited the place, or you can take help from your friends who have earlier gone there and they can provide you information and data about the expenses and all other things. So using all this data and information, you can predict your expenses. Now machine learning works in the same way. We provide data and information to the machine, as much data as possible, and looking at that data and all the information that is available, it can take some decisions or can do some predictions. If I take a very real world example, on your email, suppose you got some email and you marked it as a spam and you did it two or three times. Every time you got that particular email or a similar kind of email, you marked it as a spam. Now after some times, your system will learn that this particular email or these kind of emails coming from some particular sender or having some specific message or having some specific body, this is a spam. And the next time it will take a decision, it will predict and take a decision that this is a spam email and it will mark it as spam without you having to do it manually. So this is how machines learn. You have provided it data and information by marking that email as spam two or three times, and the fourth time it has learned and now it can take a decision on itself. So this, in very, very simple words, what machine learning is. Now if I go to the official definition, it says machine learning is the study of computer algorithms that improve with experience. So as we keep on giving more data and as it keeps on doing some predictions and decisions, it keeps on learning at it keeps on improving with every experience. And these machine learning algorithms build mathematical model based on sample data. We also call it as training data. And based on that data, it can make predictions and decisions without being programmed to do so. So we have not programmed for doing some particular action, but based on the data and information, it can take a decision and predict and then do some actions without we having to code for that particular action. And this process of using data and then doing prediction is called as regression in machine learning. Now with this very, very basic knowledge, let us go forward and learn about the components of machine learning. Now talking about the components of machine learning, there are three important components. The first one is data or data set. A collection of data is called as data set, and data is very important in machine learning. As we have seen earlier, we need to provide a lot of data to machines so that based on that data they can do some predictions and then they can do calculations and then take decisions. And it is important to provide data, and the more data you provide and the wide variety of data you provide, the better it will be. The better will be the calculations, the better will be the predictions, and better will be the decisions. So data is the first and very important component. Then we have features. Now features are individual measurable properties. For example, if we go back to our example of calculating the cost of our holiday, in this case, features can be the number of days, the airline services, the type of hotels, like 3, 4, or 5-star hotels you want to book. All this will come as features, and features can be, a feature can be numeric, it can be a string, or it can even be graphical. So this is feature and second component of machine learning. And then we have algorithms. Now algorithms are a set of instructions to solve a problem. So these are sequence of steps or instructions, and algorithm uses features and data, and based on the data we have and the features we have, it runs some steps or sequence of instructions, and based on algorithms we can actually do the calculations and then do predictions and can take a decision. So machine can do these calculations, prediction, and take decision based on these algorithms. So these are the three components of machine learning. Now if I give you a very real world example, whenever you try to do some search on an e-commerce application, or if you have searched for a product on an e-commerce application, or maybe you have searched for some flights for your holiday. Now whenever you do a browsing on the internet and you are on a completely different website, still you will see ads related to your search that you have done in the past. So it will show you ads based on the products you have searched, or similar kind of more products, or based on the flights you have searched. So the system can learn that you have done some search for these kind of things, and based on the all these components, it can now take decisions and show you relevant ads. So this is a very good real example of how machine learning works. Now with this knowledge, let us see the different types or approaches of machine learning. And before I go there, let me also show you this. So some people are confused between machine learning, artificial intelligence, and deep learning. So deep learning is a subset of machine learning, and machine learning is a subset of artificial intelligence. So machine learning uses deep learning, and artificial intelligence using machine learning. Now I will explain more in detail about these topics in a separate video, but this is just for general information. And now we can go and learn the different types or approaches of machine learning. There are three approaches or three types of machine learning. We have supervised learning, unsupervised learning, and reinforcement learning. Now in supervised learning, we find pattern based on both input and output data. For example, the decision to mark an email as spam, this is an example of supervised learning. Or to predict the winner or loser of a game, or to predict whether a user should be given a loan or not, all this will be a type of supervised learning. Now when we talk about unsupervised learning, here we find the pattern based on only the input data, and we are not having any output data. Now this is very useful when we do not actually know what we are looking for. For example, visual recognition, or putting the name to your friend's photo on Facebook, this is a type of unsupervised learning approach of machine learning. Or in case of Google Photos, Google Photos can put a photo into a family album or an office album based on the facial features or some other features. All this will be a type of unsupervised learning. Then we have reinforcement learning, and this is when a machine or a computer has to work in a dynamic environment, we make use of reinforcement learning. For example, automated traffic lights. Now, in case the traffic lights are automated to change the signal or change the lights after a set duration, that is actually not machine learning. But if we have traffic lights which can check the conditions or the dynamic environment and see which lane has more traffic, and it provides more green signal to that lane and sees and predicts which lane has less traffic and can predict and then take a decision to provide more red signal to that lane, that will be a type of machine learning. And the machine learning approach used here is reinforcement learning. Now, in case you have any confusion or doubts in the components of machine learning or the types of machine learning, do not worry. The motive of this video was just to introduce and to explain the very basics of machine learning. And if you are somebody who understands better with a story, I have written a story on machine learning, and you will find the link in the description of this video. And I will meet you with a new topic in the next episode of School of Basics. Thank you for watching.